All right, so we've kicked everybody out of the car, and now we have access to the interior. So Steve can give us a nice little demo.
Right, so I think as soon as you look inside the car from the door when you walk up to it and open it, you can really see the premium level of the interior. I think, Jeff, as you pointed out, we've got the metal speaker grills high on the door where they're both visual, and you can see them, mm-hmm. but also for the sound performance. Now we have increased the level of the audio system with the low and the lower, the mid and the high, as well as, yeah, we've got four available overhead for both front and rear occupants.
I noticed in the press release 16 channels, over 700 watts of power.
Yes, and I believe it's on. We'll check this out and see if the Bluetooth is
connected. I think they were doing USB earlier with the demo.
Okay.
Yeah, there's USB.
Go back to the beginning here. Sense that the music is surrounding you.
Yeah, it's like it envelops you.
Right, it's not just coming from the instrument panel, but now you hear the singing, it's coming from right here in the front and center, clearly.
So that's good.
And this was all tuned by Elliot Shiner, who's actually on site here today. He said this is his best work yet.
It is good. Yeah, I spoke to him for a few moments before we came on camera here. He's pretty excited about all this. And you have your, what is this, the True Touch Pad interface? Is
that
what
that's right. That's okay. Correct. Pretty simple to operate. Doesn't function like a normal scroll pad that you're familiar with, but it is just absolute. So if I want to push on the navigation, I just put my finger on the
upper top, left corner.
Yep, top left corner. It highlights that, and then I would push that, and then we're into the navigation mode. We do have a B-side here on the right. We can swap back and forth between navigation, clock, and what's playing on the audio, as well as the intent would be that then you could flip-flop.
Right, you could put the navi on the right side and then the audio on the left.
That's right.
And I understand this was kind of designed to this is designed to kind of follow the design ethos of the NSX, right?
Yeah, that's correct. So we have the driver controls here also centrally located on the vehicle, similar to the NSX. We've added to the RDX this year also the integrated dynamic system. Mm-hmm. So we'll have four separate drive modes with Sport, Comfort, Sport Plus, and Snow.
Yep. There we go. It shows it here too. The damper, so this adjusts probably throttle, transmission logic. Yeah,
that's right.
And
steering.
The dampers, same thing with Sport Plus.
And the versions that have the adjustable dampers, it will also control the damper system.
So that was one of my other questions, is the adjustable damper standard, or is that, I assumed it was probably in certain trims?
It's not standard.
Okay, all right. And it's the valve-based, not MR.
That's right, it's the valve-based, yep.
Okay, cool. So that's better for repair costs down the road.
Yeah.
Very nice, though. Stitched leather here, soft touch, the wood.
Then we've got the gloss black as well on the vents. Even the fine detail here, you can see the silver and the chrome down the center there of the vent. Just mm-hmm. those little attention to detail points that really, separate the car from mainstream.
Yeah. So one of the things I like about this is not only the true touch, but it's also very responsive, like scrolling and, some of these audio systems, they have so many things going on, but they're very laggy when you click them. Obviously, you guys have done a lot of work and specking a good processor and whatnot for this. This is a 10.2 inch full HD screen, correct?
Yes, that's right. Also, some of the controls then will show up here in the MID, as well as the top trim will have the heads-up display. I'm not sure if you can visible in the camera.
It's hard to see it from back there, but it's actually a pretty detailed HUD from what I saw a few weeks ago when I was sitting in the driver's
seat. Yeah, the field of view is also about 10.5 inches wide.
Okay, yeah. It's very nice.
And it is color, and then there are controls here on the steering wheel that are interactive with the HUD as well. So you can see what audio is playing. You can, if an incoming call or text message, you'll be able to get that indication here on the heads-up display as well.
Right. And then another feature that I remember reading about was it's supposed to be natural, very natural to speak to this system, and the recognition is very intuitive.
Right. We've improved the voice recognition so that it is more of a natural language. Instead of having to follow rigid commands, you're just able to say, find the closest gas station, find the nearest restaurant,
right.
Starbucks.
Take me home.
Yes.
Yeah. And it looks like that's probably one of the highest resolution MIDs I've seen yet in an Acura. Is that true?
That I don't know.
Okay.
But yes, it is high res. I don't know if it's the highest.
Yeah. It's pretty clear and very detailed there. Nice color and everything, but clear text. So cool. Nice little sunglass holder. LED lighting, I'm sure.
Yes.
Yep.
And then the controls for the...
The huge shade
yep.
coming our way. Somebody's face print up there. I hope it's a face print. Yeah, so this is blocks all UV once it's closed? Completely opaque?
I believe so. Yes. Okay. It's opaque, yes.
Yeah, so heat transmission is...
Right.
Okay. Cool. Is there anything else you'd like to point out in the interior? I see we have a reasonably good sized console, and then you have a slide top here.
Right, so under the slide top we've got dual cup holders left and right, as well as a foam pocket here shown, you know, you can put your phone in here. I like to put it where I can see it
yeah.
when I'm driving.
Yeah.
And then the USB here, this is both power and data,
mm-hmm.
so if you wanted to connect your car, this is where you would do it.
Now, there's two ports back here, I see, and then there, mm-hmm. is this the only one up front?
There's
one right here.
Also underneath.
Yeah.
So with this high-deck console, there's storage here that the women tend to like. They can mm-hmm. put their purse here, get it out of the way. As well as we have the aux and the accessory power outlets, as well as the assistant side USB switch.
Yeah.
Or not switch, port.
Right, okay. Yeah, that's a pretty sizable... What do you call this area again? The little cubby area?
Yeah, it's the high deck console.
Oh, high deck. Okay.
Yep, yeah. Offers the storage that's underneath.
Right. It's kind of hard to see here in this light, but you kind of get an idea. If I get out of the car, it's probably better. But here we go. Thank you.
And then yeah, with the console here too, right, has the lid to close it. We heard people like to put things out of sight,
mm-hmm.
and not have it visible. It also cleans it up, makes it look much neater.
Is this actual wood here?
Yes, it is. And then this is also adjustable, so it helps then with mm-hmm. positioning the hand, keeping it stable while using the touchpad.
So I imagine you've probably done testing, like how much weight this will withstand, because people will put stuff on it, right?
That's so, right, of course.
Before they destroy it. So.
Different liquids also, it has to go through a test, all the electronics, so that they operate when you spill your soft drink.
Yeah, your frozen mocha. Whatever.
Yeah, or your frappuccino.
Cool. All right, well.
I guess one other thing, Jeff.
Yeah.
Probably didn't talk about because we're sitting on them. Are
yeah.
the seats.
Oh, yeah. Very comfortable. Yeah, very nice seats.
Yeah, they're up to 16-way power adjustability.
Nice and ventilated. Yeah, 16-way yeah. for the driver as well as the passenger.
That's right.
Yeah.
So with the lumbar, it's a 4-way, in mm-hmm. and out, up and down. It's got the thigh extension, it's got power bolster. As well as we've got the four-way adjustable, now manual headrest.
Okay.
But yeah, heat and vent seats also available.
Yeah, I'm enjoying the ventilated seat.
It's getting warm in here.
Yeah, yeah. So this is probably also dependent on trim level as far as which
one. The vent seat is, yeah.
yeah. The heat's heat probably seat, standard.
The heat's standard, yes.
Rear heat as well?
Not standard, but available.
Okay,
yes.
All right. Awesome. Well, I like it a lot. I think you guys did a great job.
Thank you.
Looks nice. It's gonna probably sell pretty well. I mean, crossovers are still kind of hot right now, right?
They are. Our president said it's the right product at the right time.
Yeah.
You know, for the market. Sales the last 3 years have been over 50,000. It's the only vehicle in the segment, the current model, and we hope to increase the sales from that.
Okay. Since we're inside, just thought of this. I'd heard that the new platform makes this ride really quietly, and it's like the interior noise is maybe one of the quietest Acuras rolling right now. Is that correct?
It is. Can you hear noise outside the car?
Not much.
flat out there. I mean, it's an auto show floor.
Right.
And the other thing is the audio is on such a low level, but it's still clear enough that we can hear it and we can have a clear conversation.
Yep.
You don't have to turn the audio up to be able to hear it.
Yeah. Right. It's so fantastic. You guys have taken a lot of measures in sealing and as well as like, you know, probably insulating the fender wells and acoustic glass, etc.
That's right. Okay. You know, trying to close up all those gaps wherever the noise can permeate through.
Yeah, and all this glass here probably makes it
a challenge.
Yeah, cool. All right, well, Steve, great job on the car. Can't wait to drive it. Hopefully that event's coming up soon, and I'm sure I'll see you there.
Jeff, yeah, thank you very much.
All right.
Been my pleasure.
Thank you for taking the time and showing us everything here.
I can't wait till you get to drive it.
Yeah. All right, thanks.